In this video, I'm going to show you how to use color and luminance to refine your targeted adjustments in Photoshop's Camera Raw. Hey everyone, welcome back to another very exciting tutorial here at the PhotoshopTrainingChannel.com. My name is Jesus Ramirez, and you can find me on Instagram at JRFromPTC. In this video, I'm going to show you how to refine your targeted adjustments in Camera Raw using a brand new feature called Range Mask. This allows you to use luminance and color from your photo to create a mask to fine-tune your targeted adjustments. So you will need the latest version of Photoshop and Camera Raw to follow along. Okay, let's get started. We're gonna be working with this image of London, and what we wanna do is we wanna make the sky brighter without affecting the towers or the bridge. Now, before I do anything, I do wanna mention that this tutorial is, of course, on Camera Raw, but the tools that we're gonna look at are also available in Lightroom Classic CC, and they work exactly the same. So this tutorial also applies to Lightroom Classic CC. We're gonna start by selecting the graduated filter. I can click on this icon or press G on the keyboard, and I'm simply gonna make a gradient on the sky because I wanna make the sky a little bit darker and maybe add some blue to it so it's not so gloomy. So now that I've made that gradient, I can come into the sliders here on the right-hand side and make an adjustment. I'll add some blue by clicking and dragging the temperature slider to the left. And I'm also gonna make the sky a little bit darker and drag the exposure slider to the left. Now that of course affects the towers on the bridge, and we would like for it not to affect those areas. We can use the range mask and use luminance to help us make those adjustments only to the sky. So with the luminance slider, we can use the luminance values of the image to create a mask. If I click and drag on this slider, you'll see that I'm making changes to the gradient into the adjustment. What is really going on here is that I'm creating a mask that says, if something is this shade of gray or darker, then don't apply the effect. If I go all the way to the right, you'll see that I pretty much disable the effect because anything that is this shade of gray and darker will not have that effect applied to it. You can better understand what is going on behind the scenes if you hold Alt, Option in the Mac, and click on this slider. You'll see that now I have a mask. You'll notice that it's a gradient that goes from white to black. This means that the white and bright areas will have an effect applied to it, and the dark and black areas will not. And that is what the default grading is doing. The areas on top have the maximum effect applied to it, and it gradually disappears as you go down. If I hold Alt Option in the Mac, you can see that visual representation. If I click and drag the luminance range slider to the right, you'll see how the luminance values of the image start popping up. So you can see how now the bridge and the towers are darker. That means that the effect will not be applied in those areas. If I hold Alt Option on Mac and click and drag on the white point, you'll see now that I'm affecting the sky, and I don't want to do that. I want the sky to be bright because anything that is white will receive the effect that we apply and anything that is black will not. So this is a lot like a layer mask in Photoshop. White reveals, black conceals. In this case, we're revealing and concealing the effect applied by the sliders in the panel here. So now, when I make an adjustment, you'll see that I'm mainly going to affect the sky and not affect the towers as much. The other slider under Range Mask and Luminance is Smoothness. You could also hold Alt Option on the Mac and click on this slider to get a visual representation of what's going on here. Notice how if I drag Smoothness to the right, you have less contrast in the mask. If I drag to the left, you have more contrast in the mask. So this is adjusting the contrast of the mask, and you can drag it to fine-tune how your effect is going to be applied to the luminance range that you selected. While working in this mode, you can also uncheck overlay. That way the overlay disappears and it's not distracting you as you make the adjustments with the luminance range and the smoothness slider. The best thing about the range mask is that it's non-destructive, so at any point you can bring back the overlay, make adjustments to the gradient, and make adjustments to how the mask works. And once again, when working with these sliders, I always hold Alt Option on the Mac so that I can better see the mask that I'm creating and what areas it is affecting. Let me know in the comments down below what you thought about this new feature. Also, if you have any ideas of how you're gonna use it in your workflow. Now, there's another type of range mask that we could use. And this particular one uses color to refine the targeted adjustment. And I'm going to use this image to show you how it works. We have this very colorful boat here, And one of the things I want to do is enhance the yellows in this boat and the reflection on the water. One of the things that I can do is select the adjustment brush. I can click on it or press K on the keyboard. Then I can simply paint over the yellow areas, which include the boat and the reflection. And you're not going to see any changes because I haven't made any changes to the sliders here on the right-hand side. I'm going to make an extreme adjustment so that you can see that that brush stroke is affecting all the pixels that I painted over. But I only want my adjustments to affect the yellow on the image. So what I can do is go into my range mask, click on the dropdown, and select color. Now I can select the eyedropper and click on the color that I want to keep. So in this case, yellow. When I click, notice that my adjustment is now only affecting the yellow. Color range allows me to increase or decrease the range of colors that are affected by the color I selected. So if I hold Alt, Option on the Mac and click on color range, you can see the mask. If I click and drag to the right, I expand on those colors. If I click and drag to the left, I keep mainly the colors that I selected. So it's a good way of adjusting the range of colors that you want to select. I can click four more times with the eyedropper to add to my selection. Camera Raw allows you a total of 5 sample points. So I'm going to hold Shift and then click to add to my selection. And you can see that once I have 5 sample points, when I click a 6th time, Photoshop will tell me that I cannot add any more samples. So now I can fine-tune my adjustment now that I have more sample points. If I hold Alt, Option on the Mac, you'll see the mask once again as I drag the color range slider. Now the problem is that these sample points missed a lot of areas, and it can be very difficult to select all the different shades of yellow just with those sample points. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to just delete my adjustment. So I'm going to press K on the keyboard twice so I can see this white point here so I can select it and delete it. And I'm going to start from scratch. I'm just going to paint once again over the yellow areas. And obviously this is going to make an adjustment to all the colors that I paint over. Then I can go into Range Mask, select color, and a better way of selecting the yellow on this image is by clicking and dragging a range of colors. So I'm going to click and drag here to select that range of colors. Notice that the icon is different. Now we have a rectangular marquee icon right below the eyedropper icon. And I can still add to that selection by holding Shift and clicking. Notice that the regular sample point does not have that marquee under the eyedropper selection. And I can even add more range of colors by holding Shift and clicking and dragging. Notice how now I'm selecting a wider range of yellows by clicking and dragging and making selections around that range of colors instead of single points. So I can do a combination of points and a range of colors. And I think that for something like this, a range of colors works better. If I hold Alt, Option on the Mac, you'll see now that the yellows around the boat are almost completely white, which is what I want, but I'm going to decrease the color range so that I don't affect the blue coming off that tarp on the side of the boat. And now I can continue making my adjustments to the yellow on the boat. So I'm going to click and drag the exposure slider. I only made that adjustment so that the changes that I was making were noticeable. And now I can maybe adjust the saturation, increase sharpness, dehaze and clarity just to make the yellow stand out. Obviously, this adjustment is a bit too strong, but I wanted it to be obvious for this video. So as you can see, working with the range mask and color makes it really easy to target specific colors while working in Camera Raw. And by the way, if you're enjoying this tutorial, don't forget to click on that subscribe button if you're not a subscriber already. Also, click on the notification bell to receive a notification when new tutorials come up. If you haven't watched my tutorial on all the new features of Photoshop CC 2018, then I have a link to it in the description, and something should be popping up on screen now that will allow you to click on it and watch that video. Also, I have a free course on YouTube on how to use Lightroom CC. That is the new cloud-based Lightroom from Adobe. So you can check out that 6-part series or watch the single video that contains all the modules together. Again, there's a link to it in the description, and something should be popping up on screen now that will allow you to get there simply by clicking on it. And that's it for this tutorial. I hope that you enjoyed it and that you learned something new. If you have any comments or questions, please leave them down below. And also, don't forget to share this video with your friends. Thank you so much for watching, and I will talk to you again very soon.